Hello guys! In some of my previous videos I used metallic samarium, and because of it being a very rare agent in practical chemistry that many people come across only in books or articles, I decided to film a few reactions using it. Metallic samarium, as well as alkaline or alkaline earth metals, is kept under a layer of mineral oil or kerosene. It reacts with water too, but much slower. As you might notice, my sample of metallic samarium doesn't look like a cast ingot. It's a chemical element obtained by dendritic crystallization that got its name for its resemblance to a tree's body with branches going away from it. In air, samarium gets covered with a layer of oxide, so I had to uncover the metal surface to show you the genuine element. That's what a purest sample of metallic samarium looks like. Samarium powder may be ignited by a spark. It burns off in a purple pink flame in pure oxygen and in reactions with halogens. Here is a classic reaction with sulfur. There were a lot of reactions of metal powders with potassium superoxide in the last video with your chemical suggestions, so now it's time for metallic samarium powder. And here is a reaction with barium peroxide. Metallic samarium is actively dissolved in nitric acid, but samarium nitrate anhydrous can be obtained from this solution, only crystal hydrate. Samarium nitrate anhydrous can be obtained by dehydration of crystal hydrate, because during the dehydration it will lose water turning into a basic nitrate, which is insoluble in water, and then it will turn into an oxide if heated hereafter. So to get samarium nitrate anhydrous, we use the reaction with nitrogen dioxide. It can be demonstrated most simply by burning off samarium powder in nitrogen dioxide atmosphere. In order to fill a flask with nitrogen dioxide, I used the reaction of copper with nitric acid. As you might have noticed, samarium powder was burning actively in the nitrogen dioxide atmosphere, so I decided to pour out dinitrogen trioxide onto burning samarium. Dinitrogen trioxide is a blue-colored liquid, but is in fact nitrous acid anhydride, quickly evaporating into nitrogen monoxide and dioxide at room temperature. Thanks for watching, and by the way, YouTube unlocked the community tab on this channel. Usually you need 10,000 subscribers to get it, but YouTube probably found the content posted on this channel highly engaging, so don't forget to check that tab from time to time. See ya!